Today we're here as volunteers working with the Nature Conservancy and the Bureau of Land Management doing what we call the wet-dry mapping. Mapping exactly where there's flow in the river and where there isn't.
So what you do is you start your reach, you identify the conditions at the start of your mapping, you'll identify the water conditions at the end of that, mark those as well with your GPS.
12R057.
And then basically you provide that data back to those who are the compilers.
We map the river every year, and we map it in the same weekend every year, right before the monsoon rains start. So if we compare that same time every year, we can see over many years how it's changing or not. We started the wet-dry mapping project because we had a lot of questions about how much water really remained in the river during the driest time of the year. And a lot of people had different opinions about that. Some people said that the river flowed constantly, and other people said it was dry all the time. And so we thought we would go out and map it and see where it really did flow during the driest time of the year.
And it serves as a wildlife corridor. It's a migration route for perhaps millions of birds going north and south each year. It's also the last undammed river in the southwestern U.S.
There's been a lot of concern about the San Pedro in terms of it continuing to flow, and that's why we want to know where it does flow all the time. And we're also doing projects to ensure that those flows remain and that hopefully we can improve flows where they've diminished in certain areas.
You know, over the years we've had a lot of different people participate, young and old, but they all seem to have one thing in common, and that is a concern for the environment. And I think we all see a value in these surveys providing data points on the health of the river.
I think it's very hard for people to care about things that they personally don't know. And that's why I feel it's so important to have a citizen science project like this that gets people out and seeing the river and understanding what it looks like and why it's important firsthand. The minds and hearts of people matter too, and getting exposure to how important this place is, there's just nothing like it.